Welcome all to another video, Dr. RS and you, Science of Cosmetics and Personal Care Products. Today we are continuing skin cleansing and we will see about the technology of handmade soaps. So, part 54, skin cleansing. So it's the handmade soap. So handmade soaps, if you see the video, YouTube video, and look for handmade soaps, there are a lot of videos which are there to show you how to make a handmade soap. Basically take the oil, weigh the oil, weigh the sodium hydroxide required, mix it for 45 minutes till you get the trace, pour it into the mold, keep it for 3-4 days to mature, and then the soap is ready. Right? But we have to go into the chemistry and technology of this soap. Right? Soap can be defined as a cleansing and emulsifying agent made by action of alkali on the triglycerides of oils and fats, or directly made from the fatty acids derived from oils and fats. Right? So soap can be made from oils and fats. Oils and fats, we have already told, we have discussed many times, they are triglycerides of fatty acids. Oils, when it is vegetable source. Fats, triglycerides from animal source, animal fat. Now in India, mostly animal fats are not used for soaps. It's only the vegetable oils are used for making soaps. So, how soap can be defined as a cleansing and emulsifying agent made by the action of alkali on the triglycerides of oils or fats, right? Or directly made from fatty acids derived from oils and fats, right? This is the definition. We will get into it and just see what is it about, right? The reaction of alkali, mainly sodium hydroxide. Other alkali, potassium hydroxide, triethanolamine also give soap. They give much more softer soaps. But all the toilet soaps are made with sodium hydroxide, which gives a hard soap. The reaction of alkali, mainly sodium hydroxide with triglycerides from oils or fats, yields glycerol and soap in a reaction known as saponification. The reaction with potassium hydroxide also results in soap, but it's a soft soap, right? So toilet soap basically from sodium hydroxide. This is the reaction which we have discussed many times. This is the triglyceride. Triglycerides are esters of glycerin, glycerol, triglycerides, COOR, okay, these are all the fatty acid. R is the fatty acid chain, long chain fatty acid. With sodium hydroxide, you get glycerol as the byproduct. You can also say glycerin or glycerol. And three molecules of soap from each. So RCOONA, 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 this is the soap. Sodium salt of higher fatty acid. Right? This is very clear. This we have discussed many times. How fatty acids are produced? Fatty acids are produced by hydrolysis of triglycerides. under high pressure, even water hydrolysis. Water hydrolysis of triglycerides under high pressure gives fatty acids. RCOOH is the fatty acids. Right? So, it gives glycerin and fatty acids. Right? So, instead of RCOONA, you get CH2OCOR, CHOCOR, CH2OCOR, you get CH2OH, CHOH, CH2OH with water under high pressure, right? And you get RCOOH. This is the fatty acid, right? So, soaps are also made with fatty acid. When you neutralize fatty acids with sodium hydroxide, you get the sodium salt of the fatty acid and water. That's it. So, that is what the definition which we saw was made by the action of alkali and triglycerides of oils and fats, or directly made from the fatty acids derived from oils and fats. Right? So, fatty acids can be derived from oils and fats by this method, RCOOH plus fatty. This is the fatty acid. So, fatty acids can be neutralized with alkali to get soaps. This is soap. Sodium soap plus water. Right? So, saponification can proceed directly as one step reaction with triglyceride. This is one step reaction with triglycerides. Or it can be achieved indirectly by two step reaction, where first step generates fatty acids. First step generates the fatty acid through simple hydrolysis of oils and fats. And the second step forms soap through neutralization of the fatty acid. This is the first step, this is the second step. Right? It can people do in either way, with fatty acid just neutralization, but commercial production of soap at huge quantities, they go with direct triglycerides. Okay? This is triglycerides of fatty acids. Long chain fatty acids. Right? This is how soap is made. Handmade soap. Right? I will tell you, soap can be made in many ways. What happens, we will see in the next part, how soap can be made from just soap noodles. What is soap noodles? They make soap from vegetable oil and sell it as noodles to the suppliers, to the manufacturers of soap, and just add perfume, color, actives to the noodles and you can make soap. That we will see in the next part. But here, handmade soaps are made directly from the vegetable oil and by saponification with sodium hydroxide. That is handmade soap. One parameter which we studied to make the handmade soap is this saponification value of the oil. What is the saponification value? We discussed sap value, acid value, ester value, iodine value, all those things we discussed. The saponification value is the number of milligrams of potassium hydroxide necessary to neutralize the free fatty acid to saponify the esters present in 1 gram of the substance. See, for example, cocoa butter. Cocoa butter has esters and also free fatty acids in its composition. Right? So, the sap value of a substance is number of milligrams of potassium hydroxide required to neutralize any free fatty acid in the substance and to saponify the esters present in the substance. So the saponification value is the number of milligrams, number of milligrams of potassium hydroxide necessary to neutralize the free free acids and to saponify the esters present in 1 gram of the substance. So this definition is very, very important to make the handmade soaps. SAP value definition is very, very important. So I think, again, what is saponification value? It is the number of milligrams of potassium hydroxide necessary to neutralize the free acids and to saponify the esters present in 1 gram of the substance. In case of vegetable oils and fat, the esters, what are the esters? Esters are triglycerides of fatty acids. These are the esters. Esters of triglycerides of fatty acids. Now, saponification value of various oils are given here. Right? So, these are the various oils and the SAP value of the oils are given. This is only an example. We can get a big list of SAP values of various fats, oils, vegetable butters, all the things we can have. It is available. So, these are the SAP values. Or, you can evaluate the SAP value. It's a simple procedure. You can evaluate the SAP value of the oil you are using. Now, so, the triglycerides present in the fatty, the oils, when you react with sodium hydroxide, you get glycerol and soaps. Right, this is the reaction. Now, we will make a handmade soap. We will calculate for the handmade soap, the quality, the quantity of alkali required, a typical handmade soap, to with coconut oil and palm kernel oil. See now, how to make a handmade soap? It's very simple. You have the oil. Blend of vegetable oil. Heat it to 70 to 75 degrees. Make solution of sodium hydroxide. Add sodium hydroxide solution to the oil. Keep on mixing. For certain, mostly for coconut oil, palm kernel oil, most of the things, it takes 40 to 45 minutes. Approximately. For the vegetable oil to completely get saponified, when the saponification is almost nearly complete, the contents will become little thick, and when you take it in a spatula and pour, you can see it flows continuously. That this point is called the trace point. At that point, add color and perfume. After trace point reached, add color and perfume and pour it into the molds. Right? Now, or you can pour it into a big tray. It's a big batch. You can pour it into a big tray, and then what happens is you have to allow it to mature. Usually it takes 3 to 4 days to mature. Then scrap out the thin surface, no, the surface layer which can be white. You can scrap out the thin surface layers, and then you can cut the soaps to the weight, required weight. So this is a handmade soap, right? So these soaps can be sold as such, or it can be stamped for branding, and you can get a definite shape. But the handmade soaps having the finish as such, you know, it adds more value of naturalness, right? So that is the handmade soap. The advantage of handmade soap is you can blend whatever you can finalize the formulation with various combination of oil blend. You can do lot of innovations in handmade soap, right? In the look and feel of the product, right? Now, the most important thing in the handmade soap is to decide what is the blend of oils we can have, and what is the amount of sodium hydroxide we can, it's required to, for the saponification, right? Example, we will take a blend of coconut oil 70 grams and palm kernel oil 30 grams. Okay, and we want to make a handmade soap with coconut oil 70 grams and palm kernel oil 30 grams. How to go about to calculate the sodium hydroxide required? Right, so now this is the calculation. Right, calculation of sodium hydroxide for the handmade soap. Is it clear? So coconut oil, see, for saponification of oils used in the formula, right? Complete saponification of oils used in the formula, what is the level of sodium hydroxide required? Right? So now, coconut oil, we have taken 70 grams. Palm kernel oil, we have taken 30 grams. Average SAP value have taken coconut oil as 250. Average SAP value of palm kernel oil have taken as 245, meaning what is 250? Number of milligrams of potassium hydroxide, what? Potassium hydroxide. Number of milligrams of potassium hydroxide required for complete saponification of 1 gram of the oil. What is saponification? Neutralizing the free fatty acid present in the oil and also convert the esters into soap. Complete hydrolysis of the esters into soap. That is the SAP value, 250, palm oil 245. It means 1 gram of coconut oil requires 250 milligrams of potassium hydroxide to saponify completely, right? So we have taken 70 grams. 70 grams will require 250 SAP value into 70 by 1, 17,500 milligrams or 17.5 grams of potassium hydroxide, KOH. Right. Now, we are not using KOH in the final formula. We are using sodium hydroxide. We are not using potassium hydroxide. Now, molecular weight of potassium hydroxide is 56.1. Molecular weight of sodium hydroxide is 40. So we have to convert the potassium hydroxide we got to sodium hydroxide. Simple. 17.5 into 40, the molecular weight of sodium hydroxide, by 56.1 molecular weight of potassium hydroxide will give 12.5. That is the quantity of sodium hydroxide required to completely saponify 70 grams of coconut oil. Right? Understood? Same way, palm oil. Palm oil 30 grams. Average SAP value of palm oil is 245. Right? So, 1 gram of palm oil require 245 milligrams of potassium hydroxide for complete saponification. So 30 grams will require 7350 milligrams or 7.35 grams of potassium hydroxide. Right? Now you have to convert this potassium hydroxide into sodium hydroxide. 7.35 into molecular weight of potassium sodium hydroxide divided by molecular weight of potassium hydroxide, that is, we get 5.24 grams of sodium hydroxide. So sodium hydroxide required to completely neutralize 70 grams of coconut oil and 30 grams of palm kernel oil. 70 plus 30, 100, no? 12.5 plus 5.24, 17.74 grams of sodium hydroxide. Understood? Very simple. Now, what we do in handmade soaps, generally, you don't saponify the complete oil you use. For example, you leave part of the oil unsaponified as such. It is called the super fatting, right? Super fatting improves the moisturization benefit of the soap. The soap will not tend to dry the skin excessively if you have some super fatting, right? So usually 5 to 12, some leave even 13, 14% super fatting, right? See, what we do is, in this, we will give super fatting 8 grams of the oil, meaning in 100 grams which we have taken, 70 plus 30, 8 grams, we want it to be free without saponified in the soap, right? So 100 grams of the mixture needs 17.74 grams of sodium hydroxide. So 8 grams will require 1.42 grams of sodium hydroxide. So alkali required with 8% super fatting is 17.74 minus this 1.42, you get 16.32 grams of sodium hydroxide. So what happens? If you use 16.32 grams of sodium hydroxide, it will saponify 92 grams of this mixture and leave 8 grams of the oil as a super fatting. I told you super fatting has two advantages. One, very very important, it improves the soap performance in terms of it will not dry the skin excessively. Two, if you leave excess oil, then the formulation will not, by any chance, will not have any excess alkali, sodium hydroxide. Excess sodium hydroxide in the product can irritate the skin. So it should be always, we have excess oil in the formula, and if you completely neutralize, there is a chance of excess alkali also, because SAP value, we are taking the average, right? Average SAP value. So it's always better to leave some 5 to more than 5% super fatting in a handmade soap. Understand, that is super fatting. In our exercise, we have left 8 grams as super fatting. That is very simple. Now, we have 100 grams of the oil, 16.32 grams of sodium hydroxide with 8% super fatting. So total is 116.32 grams. Take 30% of this weight as water. 116.32, 30% will be 35 grams water. So dissolve alkali, dissolve 16.32 grams of sodium hydroxide in water, right? Dissolve 16.32 grams of sodium hydroxide in water, then blend the oil, coconut oil and palm kernel oil, heat to 70 to 75 degrees, dissolve sodium hydroxide 16.32 grams in 35 grams of water, add to the oil slowly, mix till trace point is reached, mass becomes slightly viscous, add color and perfume, pour into molds, allow it to mature for a week, remove thin layer on the surface, the soap is ready for use, very simple. Caution, caution, caution. What is this three caution? Caution, 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 right? Sodium hydroxide is highly corrosive. So, wear overcoat glove and goggles while making handmade soaps. Very, very important. You have to wear goggles, wear gloves and overcoat while making handmade soaps, because sodium hydroxide is very, very corrosive. Next point is, next point here, add sodium hydroxide little by little to water and dissolve. Heat will be liberated during this. It's an exothermic process. Dissolution process. Don't add water to sodium hydroxide. Add sodium hydroxide to water, but add sodium hydroxide little by little to water. Right? When you add water to sodium hydroxide, the reaction will be very violent. Right? So, handling sodium hydroxide, you have to be very, very careful while making handmade soaps. It looks little very simple. You can go through this again and then it will be very simple. Very, very simple. So, you have to understand the background behind the calculation of the sodium hydroxide required and the superfatting, all those things when you make a handmade soap. The next thing while making a handmade soap, fatty acids. We have saturated fatty acids like stearic, palmitic, lauric, myristic, and we have unsaturated fatty acids, oleic, linoleic, right? And this is lauric. The main compositional difference is the chain length and the degree of unsaturation of the fatty acid forming the triglycerides. The compositional difference in the oils and fat give rise to their significantly different properties of soap and functional properties like stability in terms of rancidity, foaming, skin sensorial and balancing, cleansing and leaving the skin dry. For example, coconut oil and palm oil mostly have saturated fatty acids. Coconut oil has lauric acid. No? Lauric acid is relatively a shorter chain fatty acid, C12, whereas stearic is C18. So, what happens? When C12 foams very profusely, when lauric acid, coconut oil soap as such, foams very profusely, the soap is very hard, but the soap dissolves very fast and the soap tend to dry the skin excessively. Pure coconut oil soap, you can feel that the skin becomes dry. So, what happens? That is why you have to judiciously blend the different fatty acids, different oils containing esters of various fatty acids. Lauric acid, a saturated fatty acid, contributes to the hardness, cleansing and big fluffy lather. Myristic acid contributes to the hardness, cleansing and fluffy lather. Palmitic acid, similar, creamy lather. Palmitic acid gives a creamy lather, whereas myristic and lauric gives a fluffy lather. Stearic acid, stable, to stabilize lather in soap. Oleic acid contributes to conditioning and moisturizing abilities. Linoleic is very, very good. It contributes to the conditioning and moisturizing levels. No, linolenic also, it's good. Resinolic contributes to conditioning and moisturizing levels and stability of the lather. Now, when you use coconut and palm, you will get a hard soap. Lather well, both fluffy and creamy. This soap will be very good in a environmental condition which is little humid, but coconut and palm reasonably gives a very good soap. But if you want to improve the soap further, you can alter the palm kernel oil or coconut oil level, and you can use ingredients like olive oil, cocoa butter doesn't have unsaturated fatty acids, but olive oil, cocoa butter gives much more emolliency, much more moisturizing. Olive oil gives, or almond oil, so you can, and castor oil, very low level of castor oil which contains resinolic acid. So you can have blend of oils. See, the thing is, when the soap is made up of coconut oil and palm kernel oil, most of the fatty acids in coconut and palm oil are all saturated, right? So these soaps stay for a long time in terms of rancidity. They don't become rancid at all. The rancid smell, when you make a soap with coconut and palm oil, chance of rancidity is practically nil, because all the fatty acids are saturated fatty acids. But when you add unsaturated fatty acids, oils with unsaturated fatty acids like almond oil, castor oil, olive oil, all those oils, you have to be a little careful, because the soap can become rancid. You have to use high quality oils for it to stay for a long time, right? So this is the various so what we will do now. I have a video. I saw a good site where you just click the formula, click the oil you want to use, what level, and it gives you the alkali required and the quality of the soap that will form with that level of oil, right? We will start the video with coconut oil and palm kernel oil, how it is entered in the thing and how it gives the sodium hydroxide level, because it completely converts potassium hydroxide into sodium hydroxide, gives level, and then you can adjust the super fatting you require, how much super fatting, based on that it gives the alkali level, right? Let us go to the video and see the video. This is the site I want to show you. This is calc.mindrulandia.es. No? Saponification calculator, handcrafted soap making, Mindrulandia. Right? This is the thing which gives the actual sodium hydroxide level that is required for your vegetable oil combination for complete saponification. And you can adjust for the super fatting, and adjusting for the super fatting, it gives the final required level of sodium hydroxide directly. Let us go and see the calculation, how it works. So here I'll open this. So here we'll see, here we will have coconut oil, coconut oil, we will have coconut oil, then new palm kernel oil, right? Coconut and palm kernel. Palm kernel oil. So coconut oil in our calculation we have taken 70 and palm kernel 30. Okay, 9% super fatting, around 16 grams of sodium hydroxide is required, right? Now we have to click here sodium hydroxide. Okay, sodium hydroxide, so it gives sodium hydroxide. So 11 plus 5, 16 grams. It calculates based on the super fat we require. So if we reduce the super fatting, reduce the super fatting to 1%, the alkali increases, because more oil has to be saponified, so the alkali level increases, right? If we increase, so if you say 17%, from 16 it has become to 14 grams, right? So based on the super fatting, we have kept as 8, right? 8 is 16. We have got 16.2 in our calculations with 70, 30. So they have put SAP value 0.248, 0.237. We have taken, this is 0.248 in grams, or 248 milligrams, 237 milligrams, 248 and 237. So what is SAP value? Number of milligrams of potassium hydroxide required to completely saponify 1 gram of the ester and the free fatty acid. So now 248 is the saponification value, that is in milligrams, 248 milligrams, they converted into grams, 0.248 and 0.237. 248 milligrams is 0.248 grams, right? So now, based on that, the alkali has been given 16 based on the super fat we have set, right? So 16 grams of sodium hydroxide. Then conditioning, how much bubbles, what is the hardness, cleanliness, everything comes here. So, right? This is what I want to share with you on this tool. So making a handmade soap, it's a fun. It's you understand the science behind that soap, why we use that level of sodium hydroxide, what is sap value, and different oils, why they give different feel, different characteristics to the soap. All those things you can investigate, and you can make wonderful handmade soaps. But be careful in handling sodium hydroxide. It is very, very corrosive, and you have to have goggles, you have to have gloves, especially when you make this in your lab, or even in your house you can make these soaps, right, with good perfumes. It's a handmade soap. It's the handmade soaps are again coming into the market at a big level. It is considered to be premium, because what happens in handmade soaps, we have the luxury of changing the vegetable oil combinations to suit the sensory requirements. Thank you, and I trust this was an interesting, handmade soap was very interesting. So get into the science behind handmade soaps. You can do wonders, and you can understand the other parts of soap making very well. Thank you. Thank you for listening to me. Till we connect in the next session, bye to you all. Be safe, be smiling, be happy. Bye.